Hey guys, welcome to Guyvergamingtv. Welcome back to Farming Simulator 17 Let's Play. This is episode, 12 now I think? 12, 13, something like that. I lose track because I do these either together or separate or all over the place. So yeah, not a lot has changed on the farm, but you will notice another building there. That is the workshop. So say you get like your big wide tyres on your tractor and stuff, you can swap them out there or buy them there and stuff. Instead of keep going down to the shop, because when I eventually get crop destruction in, there'll be a lot of tyre messing about and stuff like that, so that's what I have that there for. And behind us here you can see another new building. So this is my medium vehicle shed. So I have a couple in here. There's going to be more equipment and stuff stored in here at some point. But the cool thing about this place is it has its own lighting system as well. Yo! So you can turn the lights on and off, which is really cool. And close it up at night. So that's really cool. I like that. It is a really, really nice little feature. I need to fill some of these tractors, are getting a bit low on juice, so I need to fill them up. One of the other case tractors there is on like 40 litres or something like that, so I need to whack some juice in them as well at some point. There we go. This is actually a nice change, because in the other farming sim I had it on normal and tractors are losing any juice. Probably, I don't think I ever filled them up in the FS15 to be fair. That was really on normal. Right, I'm hoping this lot is, well, some of it's on first aid, so I'll be able to do the rest of this anyways. I don't think it'll do anything to this one. We'll go over and just see anyways. Might be too grown already to do anything. No, it looks like he's actually doing it. That's not too bad. So this field to do, top field needs doing as well. Quite a lot to actually weed, to be fair. Let's get a worker on this. Oh, that one's done, that one's done. So 12 and 19 need to be done. A bit of 19 needs ploughing. That can be done in the last one. There's a big chunk that'll work now. See how this bit goes. Yeah, see, it's not doing it again. Yeah, it's on the first stage of growth. Oh, it is doing it. Let's just be oh, it's updating now. Slack on the map, right. So they're done, they're done. They're all still growing. Two soybean. Two wheat. So if I buy 23 and 24 at some point, they're probably going to be knocked up to Canola, maybe something like that. I have to say. Trying to get a good variety going, so I've got a lot of stuff to sell. So, speaking of selling stuff, I need some money. So, who is giving decent dosh for stuff? Canola I've got a bit of, Pacific Grain are giving a good bit of that. It's going down on the soybeans, which I haven't got many of them left. So, I was feeling like this guy in the news. A bit off on the driving that. Yeah, I thought it was. Right. So we'll line up here. Didn't think I was going to get out of there. Oops. Oh, a little bit of a dent, didn't I? What did I say I was going to flog? Canola, weren't it? Right. I don't think I'll get this full. But... Bosh. Right, so I'm going to take this up here and we'll flog all this. So, not done a lot today. Recorded another couple of episodes this morning, which will be obviously before this one. And then, what else did I do? Took my mum shopping in the Mondeo. Loads of room in the back, still, even with all my shitty... jackets and that for uniform. Still lots of room for the shopping, which is good. Customise the home screen for the system in the car as well, the 8-inch touchscreen. So I actually have my Guyvergamingtv logo on there as well. So hopefully, if any of the young lads when he goes in for service and stuff like that see it, they'll have an Aussie on the YouTubes. Go advertise, guys. Go advertise wherever you can. It needs a wash, to be fair. It's absolutely bogging. It's more grey than freaking blue at the minute. But the weather's that bad. I wasn't going to bother. It's actually coming out quite sunny now, but it was supposed to rain today. So I didn't bother. I'm going to go to work tomorrow, so there's no real point washing it either, because it's going to be nasty. On the miles per gallon, I'm doing bloody well. Done 200 and some odd miles, 210 miles or something. And I still have just under a quarter of a tank, something like that. So, I was in the old ST, I'd have had another 20 quid in by now, so definitely saving money fuel wise anyway. What do we get out of that? 17,200. Not bad. But I've no canola left. Tons of wait, no. So who's giving good? Oh, that's the mill. Can't bother using the train yet. Although it is going up. I'm still not sure where I emptied it off for the bloody train though. I can't remember. Where you dump it to get it in the train. There is another set of silos. I can't remember if it's at number 10 or not. I'll have to check that out, because eventually I will have to start using it, I suppose. If they're going to start giving good money for stuff, I'm going to have to start storing it there. But that'll be whenever I get know, bigger farm going, and I've got more produce, I can put some in the silos and some in the train silo, and then transport it around in the old puffer train there. But that won't be for a wee while yet. Now coming to the road. I don't want to be on this road either, to be honest. That's one thing still lacking in this game, is a bit of life. You know, at least there's people walking around the town and stuff now, but out here in the countryside, you don't see, I mean, no cars come up this road. You know, you see nothing. A couple of wagons cruising around would be nice. A couple of trucks, a couple of other farmers, like that, you know. It'd be really cool. So as you say, I would have liked that building to be backed right up against the road, but it won't let you. That's as close as I can get it, so. But it's alright, it's enough room to park something there, or put some machinery, a couple of hay bales and something like that, so. Not too bad. Right, I like the place we're building. Again, still wish you could change the ground so you could put concrete slabs down or something so you can actually, you know, use some of these grass verges and stuff like that. And if you buy another field, use some of the, you know, grassy areas that's there. Because in a minute, buildings wise, you're limited to watts. There, if you know what I mean. Which is a bit poop. Especially some of these from fields don't have buildings. And if you want to do a lot of stuff and you want to store some equipment, then it's a bit naff. So they could definitely do with allowing you to put like dirt down and concrete down and whatnot. Alright, I'll tell you what, let's back this up and I'll show you what you can do with this. So I'll come over to this. So you can customize this with colour and stuff. I'm going to show you the tractor because that's attached to it, aren't it? I just dump this over here in the field. So there you go, customize. So you can get your standard wheels, your wide tires, all that lot. Obviously, if you have wired tyres and you don't pay for them again, nor does there. But you can take that on and off. So it is handy, especially if you're going to start doing a lot of farming and you're going to need the different tyres and stuff like that. And you have your crop destruction and stuff. I mean, technically, I suppose I could do with the wider tyres to get more grip on the soil and stuff, because I do have the ground mod thing. But whenever you have the crop destruction that on, you know, you can swap from your narrow tyres to your wide tyres, all that sort of stuff. Here, you still have to go all the way back to the shop every time. So that is actually quite handy. Plus, you can flog your tractors from here as well, which isn't too bad. So it is handy having a wee workshop there, to be fair. One thing I do wish, though, is that you could do your maintenance. Oh, that's not going to go well. For the tractors there, so that you can lower the money that you spend on them every month, whatever it is. That would be quite cool for the workshop. Because let's face it, you know, if you keep your vehicles in good nick, then it shouldn't cost you so damn much. To be fair. He's done. Let's fold that up. What else does he need to do? He has. Where has he got? Field to the left. I went that way on that one, guys, because I thought it was a bit easier on the tractor. This one I'll go up and down because it's just the way the land is. So I'll fold in a second. That should be pretty much close enough. Yep. We'll get all bothered on to do that. Right, so. So. Haven't a lot left, to be fair. Definitely need to start getting more. Well, they're all two steps fertilised. I think I need liquid fertiliser to get it on the three step, maybe. Let's see. Making money. No, it's not really. Not really telling you much on it, is it? Unfortunately. But, oh, improving yield with that help. Also on the field, you can improve the harvest for. You need to fertilize your fields three times before the plants are fully grown. Remember that fertilizer is only effective once per growth stage. Ah, okay. So technically, if I fertilize all these fields again, yeah, that should be good. Let's give it a water. Don't want to use this one. No, not really. So let's try and fertilize one of these fields again, because it's once per growth. So it fertilizes first. When it plants a seed. And then it fertilizes. Where am I going? Come on, Phil, wake up. And then I do the weeding, but is that technically classed as a fertilization? And my old distractor's a bit low on gas as well, I'm gonna fill him up. Fill her up and clean the windscreen, please. That'll do, not only is it full, makes it heavier if it's full. Right. There we go. It's a bit hard to pull this thing up here, isn't it? So that should be giving it all yourself. Another stage, yeah. Happy days, right. Apologies for my noobness. I didn't realise it was once per growth. I thought it was like once per actual crop. So. Like I said, these bags are bloody expensive, so this is how I try and make money by getting it. You know, by not wasting any of this stuff. So that's where, again, this is where this comes in handy now. GPS, you can get it edge to edge. You're not over fertilizing anywhere, so you're not wasting any of the actual stuff. I know I waste a little bit of it going up to the edge here, but you know, you've got to do the whole field, haven't you? Awesome, right, I should get good yields off all these fields if I'm doing this. Fingers crossed. And I need good yields, like. So it adds 30% per fertilisation. So this is the third one, so technically I should get 9%. Right, that should be that field done and dusted now, isn't it? So next would be this bad boy. That looks about right for me. Am I doing anything? I think so, I can't tell. Let me check. I actually can't see. No, it's not right. So I'll have to wait for the next growth stage then. This one, so what I'll do is I'll just park him over here. And then he's ready for that one. That one is nearly done. He's chillaxing. Right, so they're all getting done hunky dory. That needs to be weeded next as well. I would do that for a couple of quid. It's left all the bloody hay out. Look, I wonder if I can collect that. I was hoping to get rid of that. Look, machine as well. So, you know, I only use GPS on these missions because it's, you get it done quicker. You know, again, you're not overlapping yourself, so you're not wasting time. You know, doing less of the field than you're supposed to be doing, so it's handy to get it done at a good time. I have to bring my trailer up here and see if I can collect all of this. Don't see why not, like, technically it's not on this field, so. It's not really a great deal there, but there's enough. Couple of quid. So I'm still trying to get stuff done for my room. I was going to buy some plywood and that today for a mountain Italian, but I couldn't be bothered. I just wanted to get home and relax. So that is what I'm doing. Getting home and relaxing. Now, I have absolutely no clue how long I've been going for. Because I forgot to do my timer like a dipstick. So, what I'm going to do is start my timer. go for about 10 minutes and then call out this episode. Or maybe just finish his field, I have to see. Need the monies. So the next thing is going to be either a new stroke, another combine, so I can get two going at once, or a new tractor. I don't know which one to get yet. You know, I've got a couple of fields on the go here, so I may get a new combine, and at least whenever everything's ready, I can be combining two two fields at once, like. And then, obviously, again that way, if I am doing trailer work, I can go between the two and empty the combines out. So I think a combine would be better. Possibly one of the bigger head. So I'll have to have a look at that after this episode and see how much I need to get one. So I still need to buy the combine. I need to buy the freaking head as well. So it ain't gonna be cheap. But we'll say, I mean, I have 41 grand, so I'm nowhere near what I need, probably, but... So just keep doing missions. So it's alright. We'll do this one, then we'll call it an episode, eh? What do you think? Because this, this vert looks pretty freaking cool. Oopsie-daisy. What a Lamborghini! Oh, get me! So look at what it's like on the inside of one of these things, and leather seats, yeah. Very fancy. Actually, pretty much like the higher end normal tractors, to be fair. Nice though, I like it. Very fancy. Very fancy indeed. If you want all Lamborghini made tractors before it made sports cars. And so the story goes, Lamborghini only started making sports cars because he didn't like the Ferrari's gearboxes. And he said, these are rubbish, I'll show you how to do it. And Ferrari said, bring it on. And now look at them. I think Lamborghini are far superior than Ferraris, but that's just me. And Lamborghinis look a bit better than Ferraris as well. Well, I like that. Lamborghini said, no, I'll stuff you. So they do. Because Lamborghinis used to have... I think the Lamborghini tractors used to have Ferrari gearboxes or something. I didn't like it, so... That was why. But anyways, I think that'll do this episode, because I've no idea how long it's going on for. So, we'll cut that one there. I need to do a few things, and then we'll see. So, as usual, guys, any comments, questions, chit-chat, chuck it in the comment section down below. Please give me a thumbs up if you like what you watch. If you haven't, I don't care. Well, I do, but, you know. If you want to subscribe to the channel, guys, and you haven't already, please chuck it up there and you'll get notifications of new videos and reviews. If you want to, you can go and join my YouTube channel. YouTube channel, you're already on that. My Facebook channel. And you'll get stories on what I'm doing, gaming-wise, what my rig's doing in the room, and just general gaming stuff on my Facebook. Same with my Twitter. a lot of retweets on the Twitter as well from games and stuff that were following, and also companies and that, as well as notifications of live streams and YouTube vids. Speaking of live streams, if you go up and click the Twitch, you will see that and hopefully get some live streams up there at some point of Farming Simulator and the multiplayer stuff, which I'm still trying to get sorted because I just don't have the time at the minute. And if you wish to help the channel, please click on that donate button that is on the Twitch channel. Every penny helps, ladies and gentlemen, and I need equipment. I need a new headset, and a few of the games are coming out soon that I want to do reviews on, so if you can help with that, that'll be amazeballs. And also, if you want to buy any PC equipment, whether it's a cable up to a full system or even a gaming chair, use the link down below, guys, and that helps me out greatly. I am an affiliate of Overclockers. That is where I get all my PC equipment from. Extremely helpful staff, great prices, quick delivery, and best of all, guys, you get a packet of Haribo with pretty much every order. The Haribo Sours. Can't argue with that, guys. So, again, thanks for watching, guys. Happy farming. See you soon.